सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौघ्नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणं विधाति पूर्वं येदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो वयं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुःखेत्तु निर्मलं पारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्तो मे निश्चितामतिः। सो तत्व दृष्टि हैज गिवन उपदेश टू हिज फादर शुभ संतति The emperor has to Karana Brahma being Upasya, not Karya Brahma. Murti Pratipadana Abhiprayaha. Then these murtis which are discussed, what about them? Yadyapi Chaturbhuja Trinetra Satundashta Bhujadi Murtayaha Maya Parinamaha Chaitanya Vivartaschaiti Karyatmaka Eva. तासा उपासना च विहिता। सो यू सी इन उपासना द रूप इज डिस्कस्ड वेदर इट इज चतुर्भुज विष्णु और त्रिनेत्र शिव और सतुंड गणेश और अष्टभुजा देवी अष्टभुजा देवी। सो दीज आर रूपास विच आर डिस्कस्ड एंड द वे द उपासना हैज टू बी डन You know, even in, let's say you do Vishnu Sahasranama or you do Lalita Sahasranama, you have particular dhyana. So dhyana has to be in that particular manner when you are doing that particular chanting. Similarly, in upasana, based on the upasana, you have to imagine the rupa. You have to meditate upon that particular form. They are Maya Parinama. They are all Maya Parinama. Those murtis are Maya Parinama. The real offering, the meditation is upon Chaitanya there. So Chaitanya Vivartascha. The Chaitanya does not change, although the Maya changes into Chaturbhuja Trinetradi forms. Therefore, When you put them together, they are Karya. They are Karyatmaka means Karya Swarupa. Tasam Upasana cha Vihita. Tathapi, even so, Tadrusha Chaturbhujadi Murtinam Yat Karanatmakam Maya Vishishtam Chaitanyam Tadvichare Kriyamane Na Kopi Bheda Siddhyati. So even if you are doing that dhyana, when you have Vichara, in your Vichara you have this Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, not that Rupa. Through the Rupa you land on the Arupa. So Rupa is a stepping stone to Arupa, thereby although that Upasana includes the Rupa, in as many details as they are described, but still Through the Rupa, you land on the Arupa Chaitanya, where Rupa is Maya Parinama. Tasmat Tattan Murti Nam Karyatmakam Akaram Bhaditva Karana Swarupam Eva Upasyam Ityatra Eva Sarva Granthanam Tatparyam. Although the deities vary across, still What is the tatparya? You have to land on the Chaitanya. Akaraha karyatvat tuchha karanam satyam. So, आकार बीइंग कार्य माया परिणाम इज तुच्छ एंड देयर फोर यू हैव टू लैंड ऑन द कारण विच इज सत्य यस्य तु मंदा प्रज्ञा आकार एव स्थिरा भवति स शास्त्रोक्त आकार उपासनमेव कुर्यात् ततः प्रज्ञा निश्चली भूय कारण ब्रह्म उपासनायां स्थिरी भवति सो वन हु कैनॉट लैंड ऑन टू दिस कारण ब्रह्म फॉर सच काइंड ऑफ पर्सन दिस उपासना डिस्क्राइब्स द फॉर्म्स इन डिटेल्स वंस वन uses that methodology then the mind becomes stable or becomes trained enough to focus on the karana brahma what is karana brahma upasana karana brahma upasana ha karana brahma upasana prakarastu evameva svayameva so what is the prakara what is the way you do karana brahma upasana brahma jagat karanam सत्य कामत्व सत्य संकल्प सर्वज्ञत्व स्वतंत्रत्व सर्व प्रेरकत्व सर्वांतर्यामित्व कृपालत्व ईश्वरत्वादि धर्म विशिष्टत्वेन ध्यायेत सो हाउ शुड यू डू कारण ब्रह्म उपासना विच एवर फॉर्म यू टेक थ्रू दैट फॉर्म ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर डीटी नोइंग दैट दैट डीटी इज जगत कारण बीइंग जगत कारण What kind of jagat? The jagat, the way the Ishwara willed it to be. How did the Ishwara or Ishwari will it to be? It is the same way that was there earlier. Therefore, recalling that kind of a prapancha, Ishwara created the continuity of that prapancha in this kalpa. Therefore, satya kamatva is there. Whatever is wished by Ishwara takes place. Ishwara wishes this jagat prapancha to come about so he does not have to work hard just has to wish it so whatever that Ishwara wishes comes true so satya kamatva is there satya sankalpatva is there whatever sankalpa he does it comes true immediately there is no lapse of time or anything sarvajnyatva knows everything therefore this sarvam jagat is created by Ishwara swatantra is there therefore swatantratva is there is no dependency on anything he uses the material also which is his own shakti sarva prerakatva being antaryami antaryami comes later but being antaryami one prods that Ishwara prods each and every one to act So, sarva prerakatva and even in the form of Vedas, Ishwara is manifest and reveals things unknown to people, thereby making them interested in that, revealing dharma, revealing other lokas, and then giving sadhana to tattal lokas. Therefore, sarva prerakatva is there in many ways. Sarvantaryami, being the inner controller. Gives you, makes these thoughts possible in keeping with the vasanas, in keeping with your ichcha, in keeping with your ichcha, which is even unknown to you before it becomes manifest. He helps them become manifest. Kripalatva and has that kind of compassion. All that is given because you desire it. If you desire bhoga, he gives you bhoga. If you desire moksha, he gives you sadhana for moksha. Even if you do not know that you desired this in the last janma, he gives you that kind of janma where such kind of desires can fructify easily. So he gives you befitting sharira for you to meet your desires. Which were there in the earlier janma. So even giving anyone padogati, meaning particular life form, which is an animal's form or a bird's form or insect's form, is also a blessing because that particular insect or animal desired those bhogas which are not possible in other shariras easily. Therefore, to make the life easy, that particular form has been given. Therefore, imagine the kripa there. So, kripalatva is there. So, kripalatva tells you that it is his very nature. Tatshilya pratya. Ishvaratva. Then he rules over, gives you. So, karma phaladata as well. So, dharma visheshtatva. These are all his dharmas. So, whatever Aishwarya, Ishwara dharma you can think of, all those can be the ways to do this Karana Brahma Upasana, because you are leaving aside the Karya and landing into the Karana. So you drop the Karya Dharmas and go through the Karana Dharmas, you land onto the Karana Brahma. This is the way of Karana Brahma Upasana. नहीं मूर्ति ध्यान अस्ति शास्त्रस्य तात्पर्यम्. शास्त्र डज नॉट वांट टू टेल यू दैट ओ दिस इज लुक एट दिस विष्णु इज चतुर्भुजा शिवा इज त्रिनेत्र स्टे देयर. यूजिंग दैट यू हैव टू लैंड ऑन दी कारण ब्रह्म. सो तात्पर्य इजंट दैट इट इज आल्सो अध्यारोप स्थानीय. शास्त्रेषु अनेक मूर्ति प्रतिपादनं च न उपासनार्थम एव किंतु कारण ब्रह्म उपलक्षणार्थम एव. इट इज एन उपलक्षण. एनी फॉर्म इज एन उपलक्षण. इट इज नॉट ओनली फॉर दैट उपासना. ऑल्दो इट इज डिस्कस इन सो मच ऑफ डिटेल, स्टिल द आइडिया इज ऑल दीज फॉर्म्स आर उपलक्षण. व्हाट इज उपलक्षण नाउ? यद्वस्तु यस्य एकदेशेक कालगतत्वेन कदाचित् व्यावर्तकं तत्तस्य व्यावर्तकत्वेन उपलक्षणं इत्युच्यते. व्हाट इज उपलक्षणं? सो इवन इन दि लक्षण ऑफ ब्रह्म, जगत कारणं ब्रह्म, सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म. सो देयर जगत कारण ब्रह्म इज उपलक्षण फॉर ज्ञान, बट इट इज द तात्पर्य विषय फॉर उपासना. हियर वी आर लुकिंग एट द उपासना. देयरफॉर इन उपासना देयर आर फॉर्म्स डिस्कस्ड इन ब्रह्मसूत्र. व्हेन इट इज सेड दैट अथातो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा एंड देन फर्स्ट सूत्र, सॉरी. सो द जगत उत्पत्ति इज डिस्कस्ड व्हेन इट इज सेड दैट ब्रह्म, व्हेन ब्रह्म इज शोन एज जगत कारण, देयर इट इज उपलक्षण. सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म इज द रियल लक्षण देयर. The upasanas where the forms are discussed, as in this form the Ishvara exists, that is upalakshana, to land on the Jagat Karana Brahma. So it will be clear with the example. Most of us know this example. Kakavat Devadatta Graham Ityasmin Udaharane Kakaha Devadatta Grahasya Upalakshakam Bhavati. So in the example of somebody asking the other, somebody asks the other which is the house of Devadatta. He does not know. So the person says, how do I explain? Just have a look at this. So he points out, do you see the house where there is a crow sitting? That is Devadatta's house. So when you say that is Devadatta's house, where the crow is sitting now, the crow is sitting now in this particular time, but does not mean that it will always be there. So it is not part of the house, it is incidental. Thereby, when it is incidental, it is not part of the lakshana really, but still you use that definition. So somebody asks you which is the house, so it's a definition. It's like a definition you're pointing out. Devadatta's house is that house where the crow is sitting. On the other houses, the crow isn't sitting. So it is Vyavartaka. It will differentiate Devadatta's house from other houses. By that Kaka, the crow, being the Visheshana there to the house. However, that Visheshana is not some, it is used only to differentiate from other houses. It is not part of the definition at all. You have to discard it once you understand the house being pointed. Even if the crow flies over, it flies away, still you can't, and let's say it flies away and goes and sits on some other house. Devadatta's house is not going to change. It will still remain the same house at whichever point the passerby pointed out that house. So Kakavat Devadatta Graham Ityasmin Udaharane Kakaha Devadatta Grahasya Upalakshakam Bhavati. So Kaka is Upalakshaka. Yataha Griheka Deshe Kakaha Kadachid Eva Upavishto Bhotina Sarvada. The crow isn't always there, obviously. Grahantara Devadatta Grahasya Vyavartakasya Bhavati. Differentiates Devadatta's house from other houses. At that point of time, the crow helps. एवं जगतक कारणे ब्रह्मणि तदेक देशे कदाचित् देव मूर्तिर् भवति चतुर्भुजत्वादि रूपा. Similarly, the कारण जगत कारण ब्रह्म कारण ब्रह्म. How do you know that? एकदेशाय सम्मूर्ति. So this एकदेश means in just one part, one अंश is one particular form. Another Aumsha is another form. So thereby there are so many forms of the same Karana Brahma. So in the Upasana, these particular Aumshas or particular Ekadeshas of Jagat Karana Brahma, these forms are, these Murtis are Upalakshana. They differentiate from the others. Others meaning what? Basically the same Karana Brahma manifest as other, in another form. Thereby, the forms, murtis are vyavartaka and they are upalakshana. Really, the karana brahma, jagat karana brahma is the tatparya vishaya there. Tasmad vyavartakatvad upalakshakaha bhavati. What are those upalakshakaha? Chaturbhujatvadi rupaha murtayaha. These rupas are upalakshaka. उपलक्षणस्य च इदं प्रयोजनम्. व्हाट इज ए प्रयोजन? यद् विशेष वस्तु स्वरूप ज्ञानोत्पत्तिरेव. सो देयर शुड नॉट बी फुल स्टॉप और अ कॉमा हियर. उपलक्षणस्य च इदं प्रयोजनम् यत् विशेष वस्तु स्वरूप ज्ञानोत्पत्तिरेव. इट हेल्प्स यू अंडरस्टैंड द विशेष वस्तु स्वरूप. सो यू गेट दैट ज्ञान थ्रू द मूर्ति ज्ञान. It's a stepping stone. Yatha kakena devadatta grahajnanam eva jayate nasti cha prayojanantaram tatha chaturbhujatvadi tattad akara visheshaihi nirakara karana brahma jnanam eva upasanartham murti kathane prayojanam nanyate. So the murtis, all murtis are upalakshana, all devata murtis are upalakshana to land on the jagat karana. This is upasana vishaya. The same thing, the lakshana, when you look at the Upanishad, when you look at the Jnana Kanda, there when it is, when the Sutrakara says Janmadyasya Yataha, there Yataha Yasmat Janmadi. So Janmadyaha Bhavati. That is Brahma. So Athato Brahma Jidnyasa and then Janmadyasya Yataha. So Asya Janmadi Yataha Asya Jagataha Janmadi Yataha Bhavati Tad Brahma. That is the Lakshana. What kind of Lakshana is it? It is not Swarupa Lakshana. It is on the boundary. It is helping you land on that. Jagat Karana there in the Jnana Kanda, the Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya cannot become Karana at all. So it is Tatastha Lakshana. It is Tatastha Lakshana, Tate Tishtati Iti tatastha. So tatastha lakshana, not swarupa lakshana. So from that tatastha lakshana also in jnana kanda you have to land on swarupa lakshana. On swarupa you cannot do dhyana easily. Therefore jagat karanatvam is used in upasana. So that's an aside anyway. Shastra tatparya anabhijnyataya murtyakareshu agrahavatam shaivadinam dukkhanubhavah. Why should you not hold on to the rupas itself? Those particular upasanas of particular deities, why should you land on jagat karana brahma for upasana? If that be the question, he says it, the limited upasanas will lead to dukkha. How so? Because of dvesha towards the others, there is misunderstanding. And although it is not clear as to how limited upasana will lead to dukkha, there is an example used here. It's quite a funny example really. So I'll just go through this and I'll explain the example there. Manda prajnyastu shastravi prayana vijnataya swasvabhilashita shiva vishnuadhyakara visheshu eva agraham kurvanti. So we have seen these panditas have insisted that only their ishta devata is upasya, not the others. Syala saramiya nyayena. So there is a syala saramiya nyaya. Syala is a his brother-in-law and saramiya is a dog. So now there is a particular nyaya. This will be discussed here. So I'll just quickly go through it. Syala saramiya nyayena parasparam kalahayante cha. So they bicker about each other's deities, these upasakas, just like that nyaya of the brother-in-law and the dog. So you see in the tippana it is mentioned syala devaraha saramiya shwa. So what is the nyaya? Syala bharya sahodarasya syala iti nyama shunaha kukkurasya saramiya iti nama drishtantasya nyaya iti nama. कस्यचित् श्यालकस्य नाम उत्पालक इति तत् श्याल शत्रोः च नाम धावक इति. So names are not important, so I'll skip this. So Utpalaka and Dhavaka are not very common names that we hear. So we'll go through the story and understand what is the nyaya there. तथा तद्ग्रहस्तस्य कस्यचित् शुनश्च धावक इत्येव नाम समीप ग्रहस्तस्य शुनश्च नाम उत्पालक इति. सो एनीवे व्हाट इज सेड हियर इज दैट द ब्रदर इन लॉ दिस गाय हु इज गेटिंग मैरिड लेट्स से दिस पर्सन हु इज गेटिंग मैरिड ही इज ब्रदर इन लॉ हिज वाइफ्स ब्रदर इज कॉल्ड उत्पालक एंड द ब्रदर्स एनिमी मीनिंग द ब्रदर इन लॉज एनिमी हिज वाइफ्स ब्रदर्स एनिमी इज कॉल्ड एज धावक. Now this fellow already has a dog at his home whose name is Dhavaka. That Dhavaka meaning the brother-in-law's enemy's name. So before getting married, he's already named the dog without knowing that he is going to marry this woman whose he didn't imagine that his bride's brother will also be called with the same name. So not bride's brother, bride's brother's enemy. So the brother-in-law's enemy has the same name as his dog. And so samipagrastasya shunascha nama utpalakayati. And it so happens that his neighbor's dog has his brother-in-law's name. So it is already funny. Now you get the idea. When the bride comes home, what is going to happen? So tatra tat purushasya bharyayaha sva bhartrugruha pravesh oyam prathamaha. So when the bride comes home after marriage, it's a first occasion. Tada dvavapi shvano anyonyam sadakalaham kurvate tatra striyaha bhartrushvashvadayaha utpalakam ninditva svakiyam dhavakam bhavamanyanta. So the woman in this, in the groom's house, which is her house now, the bride's house, she looks at, there are two dogs fighting, they are always fighting, and the the women in the house, they always keep on cursing. Basically, they curse the neighbor's dog and they keep on praising their own dog. However, the bride, the newly, you know, wedded woman, she does not know, she has no idea that the dog's names are so. She thinks that they are praising her brother's enemy and they are doing ninda of her brother. So, newly married, you imagine. So, tada tasyaha striyaha mat sahodaram yete ninditva tad virodinam stuvanti iti ayam brahmaha bhut. So, what happens to this girl, this woman? She thinks that my brother is being insulted in this house where I have been married to. Here they insult my brother, my loving brother, and they praise his enemy. Tena, so there is dukkha obviously. Tena dushita antakkaranaha, tena dushita antakkarana swabhartari swaklesham vijnapa vyamasa. So she complains to her husband saying that what kind of house is this where you insult a newly, you know, the new bride's husband, brother, and then you praise his enemy. Yathatra, there is a typo here, yathatra vaktrabhipraya anabhijna samana abhidhana bhrantya stri dukkham anu dukkham anvabhut tatha eva vaishnavadi granteshu shivadi namahi karyam brahma eva ninjate iti abhipraya anabhijnataya shaivadayaha vrtha dukkhayante tatha vaishnavapi शैवादि ग्रंथेषु विष्णुआदि नामभिः कार्यं ब्रह्मैव निन्द्यते इति अजानन्तः दुःखं अनुभवन्ति. Thereby what happens to these upasakas who do upasana on limited forms of deities and give up the others, they do not know that the ninda which is done in other puranas is not of their deities who are Ishvara themselves, but it is of the Karya Brahma. In the Karya Brahma, there is ninda being done. So just like that lady who had dukkha, these upasakas will also have dukkha because they think that, oh look, my Ishtadevata is insulted in these Puranas. Vaishnava thinks Shiva Purana, Skanda Purana insults Vishnu, and Shaivas think that Shiva is being insulted in Vishnu and Padma Puranas. So there is dukkha, obviously we see this happening. We see this all over continuing to this day because of not knowing the Shastra Tatparya, Shastra. So they don't know. There is a Bhranti, just like that Stri had a Bhranti not knowing the truth as to who is being insulted, who is praised. Similarly, these Upasakas face Dukkha. Shubha Santate Prashnaha. So Shubha Santati, the emperor, has his doubt about upasana clear, but he has a new question. Uttar mimamsaya pramanyam tad itara shastranam apramanyancha. So there are many shastras, many darshanas. We have seen their usefulness earlier, but here the usefulness of all the darshanas were discussed as an inquiry of tarkadrishti and endorsed by other panditas, other guru. However, when it is being taught to Shubha Santati, who has very limited skills, there you cannot go and tell him that, oh, all darshanas are going to lead you to Advaita Jnana Kramena. So he has to be given what he can digest. And also, just because other granthas are available does not mean that other shastras, you should. There is no necessity of following them. Where you feel them useful, you use them, but then you don't validate those granthas. Darshana entirely does not become validated because darshana is not based only on the sutra. Darshana is built on the sutras. There are so many vyakhyanas we saw which are lost the tatpare and the sutras also. Sankhya sutras, Nyaya sutras, etc. They don't know that they have limited focus. They use the adhyaropa as also the goal. They don't do apavada. In Sankhya, for example, thereby darshanas can be confusing, for a dullard, and for a dullard the darshana can be end goal also. Thereby, when you have access to Advaita Grantha, you need not go to other Granthas, other Shastras, especially where only Dvaita is being talked about. If you focus on the area which helps you understand Advaita, it's a different matter. But where only Dvaita is being talked about, Advaita Khandana is being done, those kind of Granthas you should not even study. So there are people who study it for refutation. So those who are convinced so much that there is no other possibility than Advaita, they can approach it to refute the Dvaita Granthas, but otherwise it is a risky zone. So here, teaching Subhasantati, because he has a question now. Subhasantati hi swaputroktam vachashrutva puranaanam paraspara virodashankayaha samadhanam chalabdhvas sukhyabhut. So he became sukhi because he found out that there is no real virodha in Puranas and in Upasanas as taught by these panditas, but then tarka drishti resolved his doubts. Parantu shatshastranam paraspara virodashanka nivrutyabhavad visheshata sukhi nabhut. However, his sukha had limitations because he still was confused as to so many darshanas being there, which one should be followed. Ataha yachastra vijnanina paramartha satyam avabudhyeta kintak shastram satyabhutam iti punah putram paprachya. So he asked his son, knowing his knowledge, he asked him as to which darshana should be followed, which is satyabhuta shastra, just like his earlier question, but this time not about upasana or upasya devata, but about darshana. Tarka drishti uttaram. So what did the son reply? Tarka drishti, he said. So he is a guru now. He answers to his father, teaches his father as tarka drishti swapitru vachanam shrutva parama pramana bhutam vachaha abravit. What is a parama pramana there? Uttara mimamsa upadeshe evana veda viruddha. Uttara mimamsa, Vedanta is not veda viruddha. Every other darshana, if you take it in totality, is veda viruddha. Itarani tu panchabhi shastrani veda viruddhatvad ashuddhani apramanikani iti. They are not pramana, they are ashuddha grantha, darshanas. Shastras. Tatrapi veda aviruddhan aushan vedanusarikvat kechana mandhadikarinaha anutishtanti. So for mandhadikaris, they follow this. Why? Because they do not know. They say, okay, this part is not opposed, let me take that. It was validated earlier, by the way. Now to teach Shubhasantati, the son Tarkadrishti is saying that there are so many details that I have spent time across and I have inquired into. It is not easy for Shubhasantati to understand. There is so much of time that will be consumed. So he gives an overview, and then it's a fact also. When you can study Advaita Grantha and get it, why would you study other darshanas? Yadyapi Shankhya Shastra Karta Kapilaha Patanjalasya Karta Patanjalihi Sheshavatara Bhutaha Dhyaya Shastra Karta Gautamaha वैशेषिक शास्त्रकर्ता कणादः पूर्वमीमांसाकर्ता जैमिनिः उत्तरमीमांसाकर्ता व्यासः. सो वी नो ऑल दिस, वी हैव सीन अर्लियर एज वेल. एतेषां महात्म्यं च सुप्रसिद्धं सर्वेषां. सो कपिल, पतंजलि, गौतम, कणाद, जैमिनि, ऑल दीज मुनीज हैव देयर ओन महात्म्य. दिस इज ऑल वेरी वेल नोन. स्टिल only Vyasa Shastra is Pramana. Tasma suprasiddham sarvesham mahatmyam tasmad etesham vachanarupam shastram sarvapi samamya pramanam syat. Would be so, by the prasiddhi you would think that, oh, Patanjali Maharshi, Kanada Maharshi, Jaimini Muni, all these have created, then it is Pramana. Tathapi sarva vakyebhya api vedavakyam eva prabalam pramanam bhavati. They are all Paurushas. Purusha Granthas, their Granthas are all Purusha Granthas. These are the Purushas who have, Munis are Purushas who have created Granthas. Unlike Veda, Rishis, where they are not creators, they have seen the Apaurushya Mantra and thereby they have retained that mantra and given it, lent it forward. They have not themselves created. So, Veda is Apaurushya, whereas these, all these darshanas are Paurushya. Therefore, although these seem as sarvam samam eva pramanam syat, tathapi sarva vakye bhyapi veda vakye eva prabalam pramanam bhavati. Prabala pramana is Veda because of Apaurushya pramana. Vedasya hi karta sarveshwarah na eva tatra brahma samshaya pramada विप्रलिप्सादयः सन्ति दोषाः. सो नैव तत्र भ्रमसंशय प्रमाद विप्रलिप्सादयः सन्ति दोषाः. सो दि पौरुषेय ग्रन्थास् कैन हैव दोषास्. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ दोषास्? दि पुरुष पौरुषेय ग्रन्थ कर्ता इज अ पुरुष. एनी मुनि कैन हैव भ्रम. व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ बीइंग अ पुरुष देयर इज एन अंतकरण. दैट अंतकरण कैन बी having tamas at a particular point of time. A person may be sleepy and there can be brahma. Samshaya may be there. There can be doubts. There can be negligence also. There can be vipralipsa. So there are so many human flaws which will be there, which can be there momentarily in some of these people, and thereby there can be flaws, such flaws which may come into the grantha. From that purusha, in the paurushya grantha also, the which is the karya, the karana being the purusha, the paurushya grantha being karya, the karana flaws, purusha flaws can enter the paurushya grantha. Therefore, paurushya grantha is not completely trusted independently. It is taken as a pramana as long as not opposed to shruti. Apaurushya Grantha. This is something that we already know. Therefore, they are not really samam pramana. Samam pramana. So, taditara shastra kartarastu jiva eva. However, the shastra kartas are all jivas. Etesham brahmadaya dosha sambhaveyureva. So, Brahma Samshaya Pramada is not there in Sarveshwara, but then they are possible in Sambhaveyu, they are possible in Jivas, in these Shastrakartas. Yadyapi Shastrakaraha Sarve Sarvajnya Katyante, as it was mentioned in the earlier section, earlier chapter, Tathapi Tesham Sarvajnyatayaha Yoga Mahatmya Janyatvad अयुञ्जान योगिनः ते भवन्ति. सो देयर इज अ आई थिंक इट देयर इज अ टाइपो हियर. युञ्जान. सो युञ्जान अयुञ्जान बोथ रीडिंग्स मे बी पॉसिबल. हाउएवर आई सी युञ्जान बीइंग यूज्ड लेटर. सो युञ्जान इज वी कैन से युञ्जान इटसेल्फ. सो देयर मे दिस अकार मे बी अ टाइपो देयर. नो देयर इज नो अकार. देयर इज अ भ्रांति भ्रम. सो एज यू सी जीव भ्रम. सो आई हैव अ भ्रांति हियर. दिस इज नॉट टाइप. दिस य इज it is, you know, it is spaced out from the top. So it is actually the tathapi sarvesham sarvajnyatayaha yoga mahatmya janyatvad yunjana yoginaste bhavanti. So yunjana, it is yunjana which is right. Okay, so this year is connected to dakara here, therefore it is, you know, it has been separated out from the top, this yakara. So yunjana yoginaste, although these shastrakaras, darshanakaras are sarvajnya, still they are, how did they become sarvajnya? They became sarvajnya. They were not sarvajnya. They had yoga mahatmya. So yoga mahatmya, through yoga they have attained sarvajnyatvam. So they are yunjana yogis. Yunjana yogis means they have become sarvajnya through yoga. Therefore, they have gained that sarvajnyatvam, which is not the sarvajnyatvam which is true to its word. So it's a it's a stuti. So much so that there can be flaws. Even sarvajna yunjana yogis can make mistakes. Whereas Ishvara is also sarvajna, but he is not yunjana yogi. So sarvajnyatvam, he is sarvajnyatvam is not earned, it is swabhava siddha. So Ishvara sarvajnyatayaha swabhava, there is a typo here as well. Ishvara sarvajnyatayaha swabhava siddhatva Ishvara yukta yogi. So he is not yunjana yogi, he is yukta yogi. He is already endowed with these sarvajnyatva dharmas, whereas this alpajnyatva dharma vishishta purusha has become or is becoming. So yunjana can also be is becoming sarvajnya, that kind of yogi. So yogi in process, sarvajnya in process. Dhyanena padartha jnanam yasya jayate sa yunjano yogi tyuchyate. Again typo here, yasya punaha sarvada ekarasataya sarva padartha gochara paroksha pratitir jayate sa yukta yogi tyuchyate. So the differentiation is given. Yunjana yogi is who gets padartha jnana through dhyana. So that is why we say yogi pratyaksha. Yogi pratyaksha is not someone who has pratyakshatvam the way we have pratyakshatvam. We have these pramanas available, but yogi has another pramana where in dhyana something becomes revealed to him. So that is called as yogi pratyaksha. So padartha jnana has come about through dhyana, therefore such a person is called as yunjana yogi, whereas one who has simultaneous single homogeneous unit of knowledge, which is the complete knowledge, that is Ishvara, who is called as sarvajna yukta yogi. Called, that is the definition of yukta yogi. Tatra yukta yogi krita vedayo prabalam pramanam yunjana yogi kritam shastrantara jatam sarvapi durbalam eva. So when you compare, yukta yogi Ishvara krita veda is prabala pramana, whereas yunjana yogi darshanika krita darshana karta krita shastrantara jatam sarvapi durbalam eva, it is durbala. अतः वेदानुसारी शास्त्रम एव प्रमाणम वेद विरुद्धम अप्रमाणम एव. इट इज वेरी क्लियर. पंचापि शास्त्राणि अप्रमाणानि. ऑल दी फाइव शास्त्रास अदर देन उत्तर मीमांसा आर अप्रमाण टू मो एज मोक्ष शास्त्र रियली. शुभ संततिज इंटरेस्ट इज नॉट यू नो ए पास्ट टाइम एक्टिविटी. ही इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन पांडित्य एट दैट एज एंड एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ हिज लाइफ व्हेन ही हैज Manda Vairagya also, when his children have walked out that time and they have grown up and they have walked out for Jnana, he was going to give them his kingdoms, he was going to divide them. At that stage, he is not looking for some scholarly knowledge or some pastime activity in Jnana. He is looking at Darshana, which will lead him to Moksha. Thereby, this Pramanya interest is in not in karma kanda or anything else, whether he'll get samadhi, anubhava, that is not his interest. What is his interest? His interest is not in padartha jnana also, his interest is in moksha. Thereby, here you have to understand this, veda viroditvam tesham vispashtam nirupitam, veda viruddhatvat panchapi shastrani appramana. Here veda has to be read as vedanta viruddhatvat. Uttara mimamsa tu na kasmin chid api aunshe veda viruddha bhavan bhavati. So veda viruddha uttar mimamsa shastra is not veda viruddha, ata eva sa sarvata pramanam. Shastrantrani api kvachid aunshe vedanusaritam tatra drushtva mandadhiyaha kechana vishvasanti tathapi veda viruddhamsha bahulyat sutaram tani parityajyani eva. Although many of these darshanas have things which are not Veda Viruddha, but there are many more Aumshas which are Veda Viruddha. Their conclusion is Veda Viruddha, therefore they should be given up. Kvachid Aumshe Virodhe Api Kvachid Deshe Vedanusaritva Tanyapi Angi Karyani Angi Karyani Eva Iti Chet. If someone says these Nayayikas and others, Karmakandis, Yogis say that no, how it is not opposed at all. How do you say, why do you say it is opposed? There are so many things which are what you say, they are same. Tarhi Parityajani. Why Parityajani? Otherwise, Jaina also, he says, Tarhi Jainam api shastram ahimsa paramo dharma ahimsaamshe na himsya sarva bhutani iti vedanusaritva angikaryam syat. So they say ahimsa paramo dharma. This is Jaina vakya. We agree with it. Na himsya sarva bhutani is a Veda vakya. So, there being no virodha there, would you accept Jaina philosophy? You wouldn't accept it as a darshana, you don't take it as complete. You'll just take that part and say, okay, but I already have this vakya, I don't have to borrow ahimsa from Jaina. There is an aropa as to Jainas have influenced vegetarianism in and ahimsa in Vaidikas. That is not true, that is all bogus, it is all Western interest. We already have na himsya sarva bhutani. Just because a Jaina comes and says ahimsa paramo dharma does not mean so. Does not mean so means what? Does not mean that it is not parama dharma. It can be said that this parama dharma, but still it doesn't mean that Vaidikas have been influenced by Jainas. Jainas are Paurusheya. Vedas are not Paurusheya. No philosophy can influence Vaidikas, because Vaidika philosophy is the philosophy. It is the only jnana there is. So everyone may have philosophies as love for knowledge, but the real knowledge is there only in Veda, because the, by deviation itself it is Vidhatu. Vidhatu ta utpanna shabda Vedaha. So everything that there is elsewhere is already there in Vedas. All that is dharma. Jaina Shastrantu Veda Bahyatvena Heyameva. So Jaina Shastra is Veda Bahya, it has to be given up. So just because something is in line with Vedas does not mean that you have to accept it wholesale. Yadyapi Sugata Ishwaravatara Buddha iti cha uchyate. And it has said that Buddha is Ishwaravatara, Vishnu Avatara, Narayana Avatara. All these discussions we already know. There is a listing of avataras. So Sugata Buddha is included in that list. So being an avatara, do you follow everything that he says? We have seen this earlier also, it is not true. Tadvachanam api, we saw this in the context of Shaiva Tantra, Kaula Tantra. So just because Shiva has made it Ishvara Kruta, therefore we don't accept it. We look at Veda Viruddhattam or not. So Veda Viruddha, if it is, then whether it is said by Shiva or Vishnu or by Buddha, who is Ishvara Avatara, we don't care really. Tadvachanam api Vedavat pramani kartavyam eva tathapi sa vipralipsa nimittam eva avatara. So his avatara had a purpose of causing this vipralipsa. Thereby, Tasmat tadvachanam sarvatha api apramanam eva. So Buddha vachana should be set aside. Vanchanechha vipralipsa. So what is vipralipsa? Vanchanechha. So vanchanechha is vipralipsa. Ata eva sarvamshe api vedanusaritvad uttaramimamsa eva sarvatha mumukshubhi upadeya. Uttaramimamsa hi sutratmana shri vedavyasena akari. So this sixth in the listing of Darshana is Uttaramimamsa, Tatkarta is Vyasa. So Veda Vyasa has made this Uttaramimamsa, which is what? Basically Brahma Sutras. Tadvyakhyanani cha nana rupani aneka kritani santi tathapi bhagavat pujya charana shri shankaracharya kritam bhashyatmakam vyakhyanam eva vedanusari vartate na itarani. Even unfortunately after Brahma Sutras were created, there were many Vyakhyanas on them. So these others whose Khandana has been done. So you can think about this. How did that happen? So others who have been refuted, they have somehow recreated those philosophies by commenting upon the Brahma Sutras, borrowing from the earlier refuted philosophies. So they have misinterpreted the sutras against the sampradaya that was following, and then they made their own sampradayas and claimed the sampradaya also. When you split from the sampradaya, it is no sampradaya really. Going against the sampradaya and causing, you know, creating another of your own, it is not sampradaya. If you are in line, then maybe yes, you can trace back to the sampradaya and the entire lineage can be followed, but then being opposed to it, there is no link at all. Sampradaya, what is sampradaya? Samyak pradiyate asmin. Srilinga, so yasyam. Or it can be kartari also. Samyak pradiyate iti sampradaya. So that sampradaya is not there because it has not been handed over to the next in line. That person has refused to take what has been offered and he says, no, I have my own, I will create my own. So how it is a sampradaya? It is not sampradaya at all. So these vyakhyanakaras on Brahma Sutras who are not in line with Shankara, Advaita, Shankara Advaita is which Advaita? We have to say Shankara Advaita because there are others also calling themselves Advaitins. Vishishta Advaita, not Advaita at all. When you say Vishishta, then it is not Advaita. How can Vishishta be Advaita? There is a contradiction in terms itself. Vyakrana wise itself, you know that there is a contradiction in terms. Bheda, Bheda, Shuddha, Advaita, all these, how can there be Shuddha, Advaita? Advaita itself is Shuddha, so adding Shuddha is superfluous. Which means that it is not Shuddha. If you have to claim Shuddhatvam, then it is not Shuddha. So to differentiate from that, Advaita, which was the only Advaita, has to call itself as Kevala Advaita. Kevala Advaita means what remains, Neti Neti Prakriya. Using Neti Neti Prakriya, what remains is that Advaita. So you remove that Shuddha as Visheshana, you remove the Vishishta Advaita, all the Vishishtas, and then what remains is this Advaita, which has always remained so, which was always there. Now you added more, so what Kevala Advaita says that you remove the Shuddhatvam claimed by the Shuddha Advaitas, you remove the Vaishishtyam claimed by the Vishishta Advaitas, the Bheda Bheda added on top of that Advaita, all that you remove, and then what remains Kevala, that is the real Advaita. Thereby what has been said here is that Tathapi Bhagavat Pooja Charana Shri Shankaracharya Kritam Bhashyatmakam Vyakhyanameva Vedanusari Vartate Na Itarani. So tad vyakhyanani, sutra vyakhyanas are many Brahma sutra vyakhyanas. But still, they have borrowed from elsewhere, or they are Nayayikas in hiding. They are Dvaitins who have presented themselves as Vedantins. Their Pramana is not Sutra really. While explaining Sutra, they don't bring Upanishads. They will bring Padma Purana Ityadi. So you have to wonder, why would they call themselves as Vedantins at all? Because Vedasya Antaha, Vedanam Antaha, Nishchayaha, Pramanam, that is the definition of Vedanta. So discarding Upanishad or explaining Upanishads through Puranas, Padma Purana Ityadi, Vishnu Purana, makes no sense at all. Why? Because they are all Paurushya Granthas. They are Durbala Pramana. So Durbala Pramana being brought in to explain a Prabala Pramana and actually explain away Tattvamasi as not being Aikya Vakya, but as a Dvaita Vakya, saying that Atattvamasi, you are not that. For that you bring Padma Purana or any other Purana, which is a Durbala Pramana. Your process is wrong. If you look at it, these people have learned nothing, or having learned that, they are using the wrong tools. Anyway, that's an aside. What should you follow? The Shankara Bhashya, being Vedanusari Naitarani, Panchama Tarange Chayetaduktam. This has been discussed in the 5th chapter anyway. Tasmat Shastrantarani Sarvani Pi Pancha Apramanani Eva. All the other darshanas are pramana. Only Uttara Mimamsa Vedanta is pramana in toto. Shastrantarani apramanani ityata heyani tatra drishtanta hetuscha kathyate. So an example and the reasoning is given here for stating that why are the other darshanas apramana. Asmin starange purvam shastranam sarvesham mokshopayogita tarka drishti sargrahi viveka vashad abhihita. So now this may seem contradictory as to here it has been said that all darshanas should be given up except Uttara Mimamsa. In the earlier chapter, tarka drishti is thinking, through tarka drishti thinking what has been established, all those are also pramanas. They should be used to facilitate Advaita Jnana in as much as they are useful. Yatha kaschit shatru asina rugnam khanchil achinat. Tada bahihi rudhiragama agamana daivagatya tad roga nivruttir abhut. So what is said here is that two people are having a dvandva, battle. In the battle, let's say the shatru has a, the enemy has a sword, somehow he attacked this other. So let's say Chaitra and Maitra are having a battle. Chaitra has attacked this Maitra, and in the battle, the Maitra got a cut. Daivashat, so he had good fortune that the cut was deep enough in a place where he had roga. So some kind of foreign body was there, some kind of roga, which got cut surgically by chance. It was not the intention of the opponent to remove the Maitra's disease. So his roga is gone because of the attack from the enemy. So one in a million kind of a chance. So he does not have to undergo surgery now, because in the battle itself, the roga has been surgically removed. The roga grasta anga, that particular part. So that is the example used. So these darshanikas are enemies who somehow remove your roga, but then that is not the real way out, as in you don't plan it out so. So that's the example there. Tatra, so tada bahi, bahi rudiragamana daivagatya. So there, this is bahi by sandhi, it is bahi, the dirgatvam, visarga, not being there and not seen there, not heard there, and then ikara elongation is due to Tralope Purvasya Dirgo Anaha. So Rori and then Rutvam, then Rori and then Tralope Purvasya Dirgo Anaha. There is a Dirga of this An after Repha Lopa. The Repha is Visarga. Before being born as Visarga, the Repha was there, Bahir. So Bahir became Bahi. So that is Bahihi. Bahihi or Bahi Rudhira Agamana Daivagatya Tad Roga Nivruttir Abhut. Tatra Saragrahi Purusha Swashatrum Hantaram Asippaninam Api Upakarakatvena Ev Manyate. So this Maitra says, what a blessing this Chaitra has been for me. Even if he wants to kill me, destroy me, kill me, destroy me, still I really I am thankful to Chaitra because he has taken away my roga. So he is thankful to Chaitra. Maitra is thankful to Chaitra, who is an enemy. This is the case of the Advaitin, who is thankful to other darshanas because they have helped remove the roga. Tata shastrantarena api yena kena api prakarna antakarna shuddhi naishchalyotpatti vashat samsarat vinivrittasya purushasya vedanusari nischaya karanad moksho jayeta iti naivatra agraha sarvathapi kartum shakyate andha golangul nyayena anartha prapti prasangat. So it is not a vidhi that you follow the other darshanas to get your darshana knowledge, to get moksha, but if it happens, you can use them and be thankful to them. That's all it is. So for this, a very good example, you know, very interesting example has been given, and then another nyaya is mentioned. Otherwise, what will happen? If you take it a process that you use other granthas only for moksha and stop there, then what will be the lot? What is the goal, and what is the goal intended to be to reach, and what is the goal that one ends up reaching? That is explained through another nyaya, andha golangula nyaya. Then anartha prapti prasangat tasma, so anartha will be the result, not purushartha moksha. Tasmad vihaya shastrantarani api sakalani shuddha advaita vyakhyana ritya sharirika uttara mimamsa eva grahya. So tasmad vihaya shastrantarani api sakalani, having given up all other shastras, one should follow only shuddha advaita vyakhyana ritya. So here shuddha advaita is keval advaita really, because shuddha advaita is another form of advaita which has come up later. So you can assume that and then read keval advaita here. Shariraka uttar mimamsa eva grahya. So that is clear. Now what is this andha langula nyaya? So I'll just mention this nyaya now itself and then we'll read through it. The nyaya is that some kid is lost, and then somebody who is a sadist, and this kid is a blind fellow. So he is blind, he does not have, you know, eyesight, and he asks for a route back home, who has been kidnapped. You can assume that he is lost or kidnapped, and this somehow he has freed himself, wants to go back home. So this sadist looks at him and says that let's have fun with him. And what he does is that there is a wild bull. What is the wild bull going to do? He is stronger than the kid definitely. He is going to drag the kid all over the place. So this person does not know that it's a bull. The kid does not know. The sadist knows. What he says is that, he says, oh, I'll help you out. Don't worry. I'll give you a rope to hold on to. Do not let go of this rope. No matter what, you will reach your house. So the poor kid does not know any better. He holds on to the tail of the bull, the wild bull. He does not know that it is a rope. He holds on to it, and then he is dragged anywhere and everywhere that the bull runs. So he has anartha prapti. There are lot of pain, lot of dukkha to this child. Similarly is the case of someone who holds on to the other darshanas, thinking that it will lead to the goal. It will not lead to the goal on its own. You have to come to Vedanta. So hold on to Vedanta. Why do you go elsewhere? So that is the tatparya of this nyaya. So andha golangula nyayaha. Kasyachid dhanikasya putram sarvabharana bhushitam choraha vanamaniya abharanani api sarvani apahrutya tanyetre badhva vijane visrujya jagmu. So this is like the sixth chapter of the ending of the sixth chapter of Chandogya Upanishad, where this kid is kidnapped, all his resources are stolen, and then he is left in the forest. But here he is andha also. Tada tatra rudantam tam balam nirdayaha kaschid ativanchakaha ati balishtam unmattam kanchid balivardam langule tadhastena grahayitva matyajasya langulam. So he tells them it is a tail. That's also okay. Otherwise he may know that it's not a tail. So you know, it's not a rope, it's a tail. So anyway, I explained the tatparya there of the nyaya. However you interpret it, it's okay. Shigram swagram anena prapnoshi ityavochat sacha dukhi balaha tadvachanam vishvasya. So he thinks that, oh, I trust this person, so he is helping me out. Therefore he holds on to the tail and gets dragged. Vishvasya tadaru anuktam anushthaya. So sorry, sacha dukhi balaha tadvachanam vishvasya tad uktam anushthaya tataha api mad dukkham anubhuya vinashta abhut. So he had dukkha, now he has additional dukkha, lot of pain, lot of hurt, lot of wounds also. Tad vishay rupaha choraha tadvat. So tadvat vishay rupaha choraha. So in comparison, who are the choras here? विषयास विवेकाख्यम नेत्रम पिधाय. So the viveka is taken away and one is made andha by the vishayas in the exemplified samsara vane mumukshum santyajanti. So these choras, meaning vishayas, kidnap, or you know, the kidnap, we are all children who are looking for, balas who are looking for our home. What is our home? Our swarupa, moksha. So while looking for that, these vishayas have somehow kidnapped, abducted us, and they have thrown us in this samsara vana. They have taken away viveka from us, and then what happens? Somebody comes to a rescue. Who is that? Tada bhedavadi. Bhedavadi comes to a rescue, like the sadist in the story. तदा भेदवादी मतांतरस्थः निर्दय वंचकः अन्यशास्त्र सिद्धांते तस्य विश्वासं जनयित्वा अस्मद् उपदेश एव तव परम सुख प्राप्ति हेतुः. मात्यज एनम. सो मात्यज एनम, डू नॉट गिव दिस अप, होल्ड ऑन टू दिस. उपदेशा बीइंग डन बाय मी, सेज द भेदवादी टू अस हु आर सर्चिंग फॉर स्वरूप मोक्ष इति उपदिशति. मंदतमः अधिकारी तद्वाक्यमे विश्वस्य तदुक्तम आचरन् परम पुरुषार्थ सुखरहित जनन मरण रूपम महद दुःखम अनुभवेत. वी आर ऑलरेडी इन दुख बिकॉज विषयाज हैव हाईजैक्ड अवर विवेका एंड वी डोंट नो व्हाट इज राइट फ्रॉम रॉन्ग, एंड इन दैट दिस भेदवादी इज कॉजिंग मोर दुख, पुशिंग अस इनटू संसार फर्दर डीपर, where the purushartha sukha isn't there, moksha sukha isn't there, you have janana marana rupa dukkha, mahat dukkha. Ataha shastrantarani mumukshuna mlecha shastravad durataha tyajyani eva. Just like the vedabhaya mlecha shastras, we should give these dvaita shastras also a bhedavada. So there is a tippana there, we look at the tippana a bit and then we'll continue with the next remaining part of the Vichara Sagara in the next part. Sukhan Nityam Suprakasham Vyapakan Namarupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukhyatva Nirvaparam Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Annamatto Neti Minishchitamathi. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste. Hare Om.